टॉपिक इज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट। फर्स्ट विल गो टू द इंट्रोडक्शन। सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट हैज द पोटेंशियल टू एड्रेस फंडामेंटल चैलेंजेस। इट ट्राइज टू ब्रिंग अस एनर्जी बिटवीन ह्यूमैनिटी एंड एनवायरमेंट। सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट इज मेंटेनिंग अ बैलेंस इन ह्यूमन नीड्स टू इम्प्रूव लाइफस्टाइल। Sustainable development is meeting the need of the present without compromising future to meet their needs. Sustainable development is defined as improving the quality of life while living with the caring society, capacity, ecosystem, society. So in introduction, basically it is saying that it is the improvement of lifestyle on the earth while living on the earth. The three main objectives of sustainable development. What are the three main objectives of sustainable development? Now we'll go ahead. It should be sociable, desirable. Development should fulfill people's cultural, material, and spiritual means in equitable ways. Now here, culture means, here the question arises, what is cultural material and spiritual means? Cultural material means tools, weapons, utensils, machines or monuments, arts, buildings, written records, religious images, things, and any other ponderable objects produced or used by men. Basically, it is saying cultural material means the objects which is produced or used by human beings. So that is cultural material. And spiritual means religious religious offerings, the human spirit or soul as opposed to material or physical. So spiritual, as we know, is related to religious. Second point is, it's the ecological variable. It connotes maintain long-term variability for supporting ecosystem. And third one, it's the economically sustainable. It implies the cost of development should not exceed the output. Now, the next slide. What are the requirements of sustainable development? First, it should be allowed basic needs of present and future generation to be fulfilled with regard to the dogmatic demographic content, such as access to water, education, health, employment, and fight against hunger and malnutrition. So here it is saying that next generation should see what we have resources on this earth, and we should be access to water, education, health, employment, all these things we should have. And next, second point, another requirement of this type of development is to political life, which involves easy access to medical care, social and cultural service, and all other requirements of the social welfare. In second point, it is saying that all of us should be able to get medical care, social and cultural service, and all other requirements. So basically, we should be able to access these things. And third point, respect rights and freedom, and to promotion of new forms of renewable energy, such as wind energy, solar energy, geothermal power, improvement requirement of sustainable development. In third point, it is saying that everyone should get wind energy, solar energy, geothermal, all this. And number fourth, sustainable development is requirement to allow the planet resources and creation to be protected for future assets to be shared. And fifth, the concept of sustainable development also involves the following: the gap between rich and the poor. And this sustainable development involves gap between poor and rich. It tries to bring togetherness between rich and poor. Now, key issues in the sustainable development. What are the key issues? So we will go one by one. First one is intergenerational equality. Each generation should have equal opportunity to meet its own need. In the first point, it is saying that each generation should be able to see these needs. Means, like in our earthly life, whatever we have the resources that next upcoming generation should be able to see. And second point, types of capital and assets. Capital and assets are store of values, provide income, benefits, goods, services, or other things of values. Third, social capital. People and community also has stores of values that can be passed from one generation to another. People and human capital in the form of knowledge, education, skill, tradition, and other valuable activity. Communities and societies are store of tradition, customs, identity, organization, loans, and institutions that are passed on the future generation as well. So basically, here it is saying that whatever resources we have on the earth, upcoming and the next generation should be able to access. So basically, it is about this only. Number four, natural capital. It includes all aspects of natural investment that provide income, services, resources, or benefits. Natural capital includes raw resources such as oil, timber, fish, etc. It includes life support services such as waste treatment, soil formation, and other ecological processes that keep us alive. Dimensions of sustainable development. What are the dimensions of sustainable development? So here are the following main subtopics. Equality. There should be equality among the people, and diversity. Interrelated. There should be interrelated among the peoples. Quality of life. There should be certain standard of life. Democracy and governance and maturity. Now the conclusion. Sustainable development has attracted much attention in the academic, governance, planning and development, intervention space. A wide range of governmental and non-governmental entities appear to have embraced it as an appropriate development paradigm. This is most virtuous seem to conquer that the challenges confronting humankind today, such as climate change, weather, water scarcity, inequality, insecurity, hunger, deprivation, and poverty, can be addressed by adhering to the tenets and principles of sustainable development. The ultimate aim of sustainable development is to achieve a balance among environmental, economic, and social sustainability, making these the pillars on which sustainable development rests. So here I come to the end of my presentation. Thank you.